Good evening. I'm Kim McGlory. I'm the CEO of Regional Youth Support Services. I'd like to welcome everyone here tonight to another packed house. So thank you so much for coming along and supporting this great performance. This is a rather amazing production that you're about to see, with 22 wonderful performers in it. And it's great to see that we've got so many family and friends here just to come along and join in and support what the young people have created here. This is truly original works, which we're very proud to present to you.
I just had the honour of being asked to come along and acknowledge country today, so I'd like to show my respects to the traditional custodians of this land, elders past and present, and extend that onto anybody who acts custodially in our area, anyone that looks after the youth, the land, the animals, and I'll say a massive good on you for being part of this wonderful community that we've got here on the Central Coast. I first heard about the Egyptian hieroglyphs when I was about four, growing up in Dunalbyn Avenue, Woiwoi, an elderly lady, Nana Coogan we called her, told me about the hieroglyphs, and she was the first one that called it the grandmother tree. If anyone's heard of the grandmother tree in that area, she called it the grandmother tree. And when we started the fight for Bambara, geez, about 10 years ago now, I was calling it the grandmother tree again, and she became known internationally as the grandmother tree around the same time the hieroglyphs there in Carryong became internationally famous as well. I'd just like to say a massive congratulations to Regional Youth Support Services and the young people for putting this on. Good on you guys, it's so great to see, and so great to see the community getting behind it. And I'd just like to say a massive good on you and thank you to all the people who provided tickets for young people in the community who may not have had the opportunity. Some I know haven't had the opportunity to come and see a play before. So let's keep doing stuff like that. I love this community. We rock. Cheers, guys. Enjoy the show.
Hi, everyone. Thank you all so much for coming. My name's Tamika and I've been part of Playwrite for about 5 years now. And I've recently come in here as a help with production assistant. So it's been an absolute pleasure to be part of a team full of amazing and passionate actors who have continued to surprise us all with their talent and dedication. This unique experience of being involved in a production from initial concept to production always allows everyone to be equal contributors to the power of theatre and our connection to the community. I just need to make a quick few thank yous. So thank you to Gosford City Council's Community Grants, to Regional Youth Support Services and Sharon Aldrich, the theatre coordinator and producer. To Amy Wilson, the tutor, and her dedication to this group for 4 years. The amazing Ray Southern for making all our props. Amy Robertson, assistant tutor, and the amazing Kate Robinson, who's wrote this whole play that you're about to see.
Thanks everyone for coming out tonight. Just wanted to say a little bit about the play, and it all came about from a Gosford grant. The idea was to write something about the hieroglyphs, and that has been an amazing journey for us all because there are so many varying theories about how they got there. And Sharon Aldrich kindly organised a site tour for us all to go up there. Some local Indigenous youth took us through the rock carvings and explained how the area was very much a sacred women's and men's site. And then we came to the hieroglyphs. Prior to getting to the hieroglyphs, we were all sort of, what is this all about? And as we reached the rock and clambered up the narrow passage, upon which two large walls were meticulously engraved with Egyptian hieroglyphs, our group went silent with the scale and the awe of the place. We saw what looked like a deep shaft, and stories began to form in our minds of Egyptian burial places and collaboration with our Indigenous brothers. Now, we couldn't write a story just about the glyphs alone without bringing light to the mighty work of a few determined and integrity-driven folk who chose to camp out at Bambara Road for 89 days after their more passive objections to stop what would have been the largest development in a national park were ignored by local government. We live in a world of pro-development, and no one is against bettering our life, the quality of our life, but not at the expense of the land, and especially this land. One only has to visit this place to feel its presence.
So this play is dedicated to those activists who didn't give up. And special mention goes to Jake Kassar, who... yep. who humbly gave 8 years of his time to getting the land successfully protected and preserved for future generations. Great, Jake. Yeah. I'll just leave you with one last story. What touched me greatly was the two Indigenous lads, Anthony Freeman and Jesse Hodges, who gave us the site tour and their amazing ability to allow stories to coexist. And possibly that's why Aboriginal culture has survived for so long. As Anthony said, I might tell you a story, Jesse may tell you a story. All our stories can be true at once. You've just got to decide what truth feels right for you. Okay.
Thank you. I won't speak for too long because I know we're all pretty keen to get going, but I just wanted to say that it has been a genuine delight to work with so many enthusiastic and passionate actors and directors. And as an emerging writer, this has been a brilliant opportunity. And the chance to bring these stories to the stage has also been a real honour. There's a great diversity of stories here on the coast, and I think that these stories need to be told more often and to be really celebrated more often because it's a great place to live and it's a great place to bring stories about to. And thank you for everyone for your support, and I do hope you enjoy our play.
Welcome! My name's Tobias Jones, and today we're going to talk about two subjects very close to my heart. Firstly, we're going to remember the life of Charlie Watkes, a veteran, an environmental activist, a friend and ally of many, including myself. He died not long after my last interview with him. Anywho, we are also going to talk about the successful saviour of the Karen Reserve, home to the mysterious hieroglyphs. Today we are joined by Ellen and Rowan, environmental activists, Theodore from the local council, and Richard from the Sydney Egyptologist Society, and Mary. Anywho, we'll go to Ellen first.
Thanks, Tobias. First, I wanted to say hieroglyphics aren't the main attraction of the site. We really wanted to emphasise on the ecological merits and the natural beauty of the place.
Excuse me, did you just laugh at her?
Oh, no, certainly not at her, no. I have great respect for Ellen's ability to persevere through all obstacles. It's just that I've never seen much beauty in the place, you know? It's all tangled gum trees and wild bush.
I suppose you'd rather something sterile and old English with a few peacocks and a big fountain then.
Well, personally, I prefer the desert, but no, being serious, no offence to Ellen or anything, but I think the glyphs are the main attraction.
Can you do some science thing to find out how old they are? Carbon dating or something?
Well, along those lines, it was quite an unusual little problem. You see, there was a professor quite some years ago who mysteriously vanished.
It's for the best, you know. I remember that man. It was a long time ago, great, but I remember. Your profession didn't lose anything from the loss of him.
Charlie knew him too, didn't he? I don't think Charlie ever liked him much.
No, Charlie never did like Professor Douglas.
Professor Douglas, yes. That was the man.
There was no doubt in your mind, is there, that these carvings were faked? They're the work of a madman. Criminals, surely?
Well, I don't know who did them. It remains unknown, but nobody has ever claimed them.
They're certainly not done by actual ancient Egyptians. They're not in that sense genuine.
Oh, no, certainly not.
We never said it was. I keep trying to tell people this is more than about just a rock.
Although, Charlie was very attached to the rock itself. I sometimes wondered, do you know, if he was the one to do the very first carvings?
Charlie? Really? I can't imagine that.
He wasn't always old, neither was I.
Whoever did them, they had a very skillful knowledge. They had a very great knowledge in hieroglyphics, and they had a lot of free time too, and they were very skillfully done.
You could call vandalism skillful, I suppose.
You consider them vandalism?
I don't think they merit any better description. Personally, I'd like them gone, wiped out, you know?
You want the whole place wiped out? All the plants, all the animals, the river, the Aboriginal sites too. Because I know your type all too well.
I'm going to have to take that as a comment, Ellen.
Censorship.
It's good sense.
Merely my role as adjudicator, I assure you both. Anyhow, what was it like living as protesters for so long, living in a tent city?
Well,
it was pretty horrible. There were awful toilets, awful showers.
I would have joined you, only it was no place for an old lady, and my friend Sue has been rather sickly.
It's fine, we never blamed you. Despite the lack of facilities, it was quite a lovely community spirit.
Well, there's kinds of spirits too, I hear.
Pardon?
Some nonsense about a spirit medium. Heard that through my grapevine. The news came to me in a timely fashion, but I don't think the community has secrets from the council.
But I never... Who told you?
My assistant, Fletcher, your fellow protester. He kept me up to date.
Wait, Fletcher! Drunk Fletcher! Are we thinking of the same man?
Fletcher, bring your face over here. My assistant. Terrible phone reception in the middle of nowhere, but he got the job done.
I can't believe this!
It was a bit of fun. You should see the look on your faces. Now, if you don't mind, I've got work to get back to.
I wonder if Charlie knew. Nothing much did slip by him, you know.
I have no idea. But it was incredibly immoral of you to infiltrate us like that.
I'll have to tell Sue. And Janet, oh, she'd have loved this.
On that note, Theodore, there some spirit mediums may be legitimate. I've seen things I can hardly understand.
Yes, but that still doesn't make me believe in ghosts.
Ghosts or no ghosts, the Carrying site's officially preserved. I was there during the final weeks of protest. I met many people and heard many stories. Charlie, rest his soul, was our chief storyteller. It seems only fitting that we end this segment with a part of his interview, where he talks about his life and a place that means so many things to so many people. Charlie, before we begin, thank you so much for attending this interview. Anywho, you've known this rock since you were a child, is that true?
Oh yeah, it's hardly changed.
Really? After all these years?
Well, some things have changed. I've changed. I never used to be this old and wrinkly. No, it's stayed the same. That's why it's so important. That's why we've got to protect it. Some things never need to change.
No, you're right. The rock has a long history, and not just for you. Many people have had theories about it over the years.
Oh, there's not a story you can tell me, young man, that I haven't heard 10 times before. People have always been fascinated.
And we still are. It's remarkable. I wonder, for me, for the audience, if you can remember this rock as you were a child.
My memory's not what it was. I would have been very young, long before the war. Oh, I used to show them. We used to play together. That's it. We used to play together.
Hey, wait up!
Adam, can't you see me, Adam? Can't you see me?
You know I can't, Charlie. Slow down. I'll trip.
Watch out for the snake, Adam!
Snake? What snake?
She's teasing.
She's always teasing. She's so
mean. I'm not.
I too.
This isn't fair. You guys aren't playing fair.
Who want me playing fair?
I've never been to this rock before. I could fall off a cliff and die.
And then we'll be sorry forever.
There aren't any cliffs. Yeah, only snakes.
Shut up, Eliza.
Oh. I got you.
You tricks. Let's not play.
He still got you, Charlie. Play fair. Adam, give him the blindfold.
Bossy boots.
I'm not.
Two. Okay, stop.
And no picking.
I don't need to pick. I know this place at the back of my hand.
Really? Oh. How many fleckles are on the back of your hand?
10?
Charlie, I think you need your eyesight. There's only 3 fleckles on this hand.
Charlie!
Catch me again!
Are you okay? What happened?
I tripped.
Let me see your hands.
Big baby.
I'm not a baby. This is all dumb Charlie and his dumb rock's fault.
My rock isn't dumb.
Yes, it is. It's dumb and it hurt me.
It's not dumb.
Will everybody please stop shouting?
Your hands are fine. Do you want to keep playing?
say sorry first.
To the rock?
Yes.
Sorry, rock.
And the rock is sorry at her. You didn't mean to, and it's the best in the world, right?
Right.
Charlie, you're really weird.
Can we keep playing now or what?
Yeah.
You're still it, Charlie.
Those were the good old days, long before the Boer War, long before we had to grow up. The war changed everything for you, didn't it? Everything. There wasn't a place nor person that wasn't changed. Sometimes for the better, sometimes not. Mostly not. Actually, one of the first stories comes from the war.
Stories about the hieroglyphs of the rock?
Yeah. It's kind of personal. Shall I tell it to you?
Yes, I'm sure we'd all love to hear it.
Maybe I shouldn't tell you. War isn't something you really tell. Let me take you back, young man. I'll show you.
We were all up for an adventure. We signed up pretty much as soon as the war was declared and got shipped over to serve in North Africa. It was 1941. We were so naive. Thought we'd knock them over in one punch.
Down, Charlie. Sun's up.
I'll do anything for a breeze.
You'll be shot. Psst. Anyone got a smoke?
Yeah.
Thanks.
This warm water. What I do for something cold?
Cold beer, all right?
Yeah, one without sand taste.
I got sand up my bum.
I can too.
Jesus, these fries are something else.
They're on the surface, these rats. I got a nibble on my finger and I have a kip. They're off the blood.
So am I.
Those Germans call us rats.
Bloody oath, mate. Jerry can't smoke or bomb us out.
Take that pod. Get him while they're dozing. Dopey lot.
Hope so. I'll stick with you.
The recon team sent posters due northeast.
Okay.
Alright. Don't make a sound. Keep your body mug down. I'll lead, you follow me, okay?
Okay.
Radio.
Got your back, Will.
Ah! Ah!
Ray!
Ray! No!
We have to get this way! I'll have to go up more.
Let's get him to the medic!
Ray!
Ray, you'll be okay! Ray, he's been wounded terribly. Come on, let's go!
We have to get him back.
Come on!
Our ships could only safely leave the harbour on dark, moonless nights. Ray had to wait 6 days before his hospital convoy could try their luck at evacuation. It made no difference. The Jerry bombarded the Narrows till nothing was left afloat. There were no survivors. I had to write a letter home to Mother.
Got any sixes?
Go fish. Any A's? The boat's coming tomorrow. It's to see sweet Annie's face. It's such a peachy.
Easy! That's my sister you're talking about.
Yeah. I think we're finally getting out of this hellhole. Almost the flies.
And the dust.
But don't get too excited. The war's not over yet.
The boat's coming tomorrow. We're leaving.
Except to her.
Yeah, that's tough.
Yeah. Well, my ration's up. I'm gonna hit the ciggy tent. Need any?
No, I'll go. I've got to get some paper to write to my wife.
Thanks, Will. You're too good to me. Well, I'm going to get some shut-eye. Wait for the dust to pass.
Okay.
Up in the mess, some Stuka planes, those bloody German bombers, came out of nowhere, leaving no time to get underground. The cigarette tent got flattened. We never saw Will alive again. He was killed, just short of leaving this hellhole.
Come along, dear. You must set the table for dinner. When is Adam expected back from work?
6 o'clock, ma'am.
You don't need to be so formal, Anne. We're family now.
Sure, of course. Oh, sorry.
Enough of that. The good glasses. Let's use them. We have reason to celebrate.
It's been a whole week since Adam started his new job. I do hope this job sticks. You know, he hasn't had the best run.
I can imagine how much you want to get a place of your own.
Yes, Charlie and Eliza recently purchased some land to build their home.
Ah, he's a bit late. Where is he?
Hello, darling. Let me take your coat.
Yes. Okay.
Adam, you're late. Never mind. Let's sit down to eat. Anne's made a beautiful rose.
Yes. Okay.
So, shall we say grace?
For what we're about,
what we're about
to, receive,
to receive,
may we be eternally grateful.
So, Adam, how was your first week at work?
I don't want to talk about it. Look, cheers to the eternal suffering of the soul.
Must you, Adam? So dreadfully tiresome.
I must apologise. The meat's a little overdone.
It's perfectly fine, Anne. The potatoes are crispy yet tender. Let me propose a toast. Adam's new clerical career.
This wine. It's the colour of blood.
To Adam's fruitful future.
To Adam. So, how was it at your new job?
Okay. I got fired.
What? Oh my goodness, what is wrong with you?
I shouldn't be here, that's what. It should be him. Don't, Annie. Doesn't make anything better.
Don't say such dreadful things. War is cruel. It took many lads too young. I'm sure Heavenly Father is looking after Will. I know he is.
Adam, you can't change anything.
The printing press. It kept making this bang, bang, banging noise. I had to go hide in the bathroom. Mr. Johnson sent Gerald in to get me. I couldn't breathe. It wouldn't stop. Later he threw a bucket of cold water on me. Told me to pull myself together. He called me back into his office. Said he no longer required my services. He paid me out for the week.
Oh, what a dreadful mess. I'll give Alan a call. I've no...
No, please. Don't, Mother. I don't want to go back. The noise. It brings it all back.
How about you just have a...
No, Annie, just leave me alone.
I was just trying out my new colours. Does my hair look okay?
You look beautiful, Lizzie. It's 6 o'clock. They should be here soon.
I wonder how young Billy is going. He just turned 2 last week.
I can ask him yourself. Look, here they are.
Hi, Annie and Adam. I'm so glad you could make it.
It's great to be out of the house without the baby.
How is he?
Divine and so tubby. That rolls down to his knees.
How's he been, mate?
Okay, I guess. Just... tired.
Or if this would cheer you up. Ladies, shall we go in?
Yes! Let's!
Adam, what is it? The movie?
I can't get the stop!
What? It's just a movie.
It was so loud! Don't you remember how loud it was?
You mean
all the bloody time!
You mean the war? Yeah, but it's over.
No, I can't look at her and not think of him. It should be him.
Who? What do you mean?
Will! He should be with Annie, not me.
Look, Adam, it sucks that Will died. And I miss my brother Ray every day. And I know how much you care for Annie.
I wanted those ciggies.
Mate, it's useless going over this. We've got families now. Ray and Will would want us to go on.
No, I'm a fraud. A fake. I can't go back in there. I'm going to the pub.
But Adam, what do I tell Annie?
Where's Adam?
He's gone.
Oh.
Sorry, I better get back in there.
Okay, I'm just going to use the toilet.
Annie.
John, what are you doing here?
I had to see you.
Not now, I've got to get back in. The movie's about to start.
But when can I see you?
I don't know yet. I shouldn't be doing this.
You've tried and he doesn't provide for you. You're too environment of your life without. You've tried and he doesn't provide for you.
But I'm married and Adam is ill.
You can't let it ruin your life. Ruin your chance to
have. Please stop! I must go.
was that the last time you saw Adam? And what has his story got to do with the rock?
I'm getting there. You need to slow down a bit. Learn some patience, for Christ's sake. The last time I saw Adam, I was walking in the national park. Would have been about 1960, I guess. I was walking up to my favourite rock, as I always love to do.
Here, I continue my work. Absolution, the goddess of Mutt. Ah, where is it? Which one? Ah, yes. This will do nicely. And on this fine, fine skin. Goddess of Mutt, you will devour my soul. As Anubis weighs my heart on the scale against the feather of my hat. Please, see this work as a confession of my sin. I'm guilty. I deserve to suffer in damnation. I survived when so many didn't. Why? Why? Goddess of Mutt, you will devour my heart, as it is unworthy. I married my best friend's girl. She wanted it, to make the grief better. We both missed him so, so much. Why'd you take him, not me?
Adam? Huh. Is that you? Adam, it's me, Charlie.
I'm busy.
I haven't seen you for ages. 10 years.
What do you want? Can't you see I'm working?
What's that? That's gambling. It's dark. I mean, look at those rocks.
It's a tomb.
Wow. Who would have thought?
It's a tomb of a Mosenik and Akin and Eden. There are two brothers. They are found entombed nose to nose in a close embrace.
Right. So you're looking after it.
I'm doing more than that. I'm continuing their story. This is my life's work. They were joined in life and joined in death. Is that wrong?
Oh, I didn't say anything.
No, I know what you're thinking. Is that bad? Why?
Look, just calm down.
Yes, it's true. They did find love. Love that couldn't have been found in a wife. Now get out of here before you regret it.
I didn't come here to upset you, Adam. You wouldn't hurt a fly.
No, leave me alone. Go away.
Okay, I'm leaving.
Now, before we conclude this brilliant interview, I want to say this. That wasn't the only mystery surrounding the rock. We've all heard many controversies as well. People have gone missing.
Missing? Nah, I don't know anything about that, mate. Maybe you're thinking about the other rock, the one with the schoolgirls?
Picnic and Hanging Rock?
Ah, that's the one. No, we never had any trouble like that.
Oh, really? I'm just wondering. A man in the 70s, we've all heard it, has gone missing.
No.
You didn't know anything about that, would you?
Nah, sorry, I can't tell you anything about that subject. But I will tell you this. This rock of mine, it keeps its secrets. Old men will too, but I really couldn't say anything on that subject.
He always starts like this.
Yes, the pressing. You know, the first time I thought he didn't realise what he was doing. I thought he thought my foot was a rock or something.
Oh, Sue.
I know, it was worse than that though. I thought if I told him, he'd be all embarrassed.
Oh, sorry, Professor Douglas, sir. It just so happens that you have your foot on my foot.
Janet, please don't be awful about it. I was so embarrassed.
You didn't really say that. Not really. To Professor Douglas.
Yes, I did. I know. It was awful.
What did he say? What happened?
Well, he said, I guess I'll just have to move it then. And then he...
Ah, no, stop.
Do you suppose he gets married too?
Mary? No, Professor...
Professor Douglas is disgusting, but he's not that disgusting. Don't make me vomit.
I suppose.
Why? You haven't seen anything, have you?
Oh, no, no, no. Let's talk about something else. The rock.
You know, I sometimes think he did it himself.
Did what himself?
The glyphs, you ninny. How come nobody has ever written a paper about them before? If they're so old and ancient, as he says, I think he put them there himself to be the first person to discover them.
But Janet, think about it. That can't be right. The glyphs are really old. He can't have just done them.
He probably did them years ago and then waited until they were old enough to study.
I suppose. I know this may sound silly, but tomorrow maybe we should...
Ah, girls. How lovely to have you all gathered here together. Okay. Now, I wanted to talk about our plans for tomorrow. After all, we can't go in without protection now, can we? So, sunscreen is a must for those of a pale complexion. Never mind. Also, hats. We can't forget hats. And I thought we might bring some cake or something absolutely scrumptious like that. Just to eat on the way. And protective shoes, naturally. After all, we wouldn't want any of your toes getting bitten by any snakes or spiders or dingoes.
Dingoes? There aren't any. Not round here.
Well, better be safe than sorry, as you'll know, Mary. Well, no matter. I have to be going. I have a wretch... I have a word with that wretch Phyllis. So, I can't be late. But I shall see all your lovely faces, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, tomorrow morning.
Find a really big stick.
A big stick? Why?
You know why.
Maybe I don't.
You do.
Well, pretend I don't. Why the big stick? You aren't planning on hitting me, are you?
Nah, I only hit things that bite.
But I thought you said we wouldn't have to worry about dingoes.
You won't.
Then don't worry about the big stick then. I'm sure you'll be fine. If anything, I envy you.
What?
Well, you're the expert, aren't you? I'm sure you practically grew up at this rock or something.
Janet!
Excuse me?
Oh, don't take it personally. You know what I mean.
Maybe I don't.
Don't be stupid. Well, stupider.
How about you explain to me then, seeing as I'm so stupid.
You poor thing. All I meant was, it'll be like your natural habitat, won't it? Just like home.
No, it won't. You know where my home is. I live two streets from you.
You know what I mean, though. I wouldn't want to say anything.
Then maybe you shouldn't. Say anything. I know what you're trying to say, trying to do. I'm not stupid, and I'm not cruel either. But you know what? I reckon you could be both!
You shouldn't wind her up like that.
Why not?
I mean, we'll be stuck with her tomorrow, won't we? Out in the bush?
True. If we get lost, she'll be the one to tell us what maggots are the edible kind.
Janet, please.
Sue, weren't you saying something before they came in? Something about sounding silly?
Oh yes, I forgot. I was going to say, tomorrow, out in the bush...
Get to the point, come on.
Well, it'll be very isolated. And I mean, I was hoping we could stick together. I don't really fancy being one-on-one with Professor Douglas somewhere, so...
Oh yes, I see. You and I can stick together, like glue if you want.
And I thought Mary might want to.
Would you please stop bringing her up? Mary, as if. If we're sticking together, it has to be you and me. I'm not sticking with her, not for any money.
Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't mean... So you'll stick with me then?
Promise.
Thanks. Thank you.
Girls, another native!
believe this one is Gavaleus, if I remember correctly.
You mean Grevillea? Beautiful...
Well, a relative of the wattle, and wonderful, as it happens, for the local birds.
It's not...
What?
It's not related to the wattle.
Ah. Well, you can't deny that they're wonderful for the local wildlife.
No, that is true.
Ah, Mary, what would I do without you? Sorry, silly old me. Don't worry about it.
How close are we to the rock now, sir?
Ah, it shouldn't be too far. Just past these ghastly, ghost gums. Actually, it should be right in front of us.
It is.
What?
Look, it's right in front of us.
Oh, wow.
Who is that man?
Is he for real?
He's really real. He's our professor.
Your professor? Do you feel safe?
None of us do. I don't know who you are,
I'm Charlie.
Well, I'm Mary. Please keep following us. If something happens, I...
Don't worry. I'll keep an eye on you.
Thank you.
Is it volcanic?
Oh, perhaps. It was. Once. Years ago. It's bigger than you expected. Hey. Would you say it's a hot day, Sue?
Well, yes.
If anyone feels unbuttoning a bit, go right ahead. It's not this sort of formal university atmosphere, is it? No. The revolution of the 60s was almost a decade ago now, so no need to feel prudish.
No, okay. No matter. That's why I've got my bag.
I was expecting more of them.
Well, that's why I have these tools here.
Thought we could add to what's already here. Make our mark, so to speak.
Sir? But wouldn't that be tampering with what's already here?
No, we're not changing anything, really. Just adding a few more.
But, sir, isn't that still...
No! No, Mary. If you have a problem with what I am saying, you can walk right back down the hill.
On my own?
Yes. I'm sure you'll be fine. Use the tracker skills or something.
Tracker skills?
Maybe, Mary, it'd be better if you just did as he asked.
Quite right, Sue. I always... You a sharp girl?
Sorry, I thought I saw a snake. It was actually just a shadow moving in the grass. Sorry.
Right. Of course it was.
No matter.
Here. Pick a symbol, use your tools, and make your mark on this wonderful structure. It's quite fascinating, isn't it? You know, no one's really gotten under the skin of this place, exposed it, seen what's really underneath. I found it positively fascinating. And to have such helpful little playmates such as yourself. Well, let's just say I'm a very lucky man.
This isn't what I thought we'd be doing.
I know, this is manual labour, slave stuff, or servants at least. We're not even getting paid.
You don't consider the sight of Professor Douglas's glistening chest proper compensation, do you?
Yuck.
Sometimes I think you're prude.
I am not. My cousin went to Woodport, you know.
That's your cousin, though, not you.
Well, I would have gone if I was older. Davy says he's going to give me disco lessons.
Let's not talk about Davy.
Shh. I think they're talking.
Who?
Who do you think, stupid? Mary and Professor Douglas.
You know, you could only ever see your skin under electric lighting before. The difference is striking.
Really?
Yes. Be sure you're not too hot or bundled up like that.
I'm fine, thank you.
Surely you're worried that your luscious Amazonian skin will burn.
Mary's from Amazon?
Shush.
Well, I wouldn't say luscious. No, I get terrible eczema. Yes, I'm rashy all over.
Oh no, I'm sure it's not that bad.
Oh, but I am scaled like a lizard.
Oh well, it wouldn't matter to me.
I'm so sorry. I'm so terribly sleazy. I mean, sneezy. Just at the moment, I really need to grab a tissue. Mucus is so unattractive. You don't find mucus attractive, do you?
Well, no.
Exactly. No. Let me get a tissue.
Mary!
Oh, Sue! So you were standing there, watching the whole thing. Laughing, I guess.
No!
Well, maybe a bit.
I can see what you're doing. Sticking together, throwing me to the
sharks. Sharks? In what river?
You. I hate you, I do. I hate you!
Boo-hoo. Go back to painting caves or whatever it is your type do.
My type? What's my type exactly? The type that gets high distinctions? When people like you can hardly manage a pass?
We know how you get such good marks. Don't you worry. We saw you getting cozy with Professor Douglas.
That? That's not what happened, and you know it. You know it. You both just stood there watching, and you did nothing.
Mary, I'm sorry.
Shut up, Sue.
Bother. I've got to go. I can't do this.
Well, that was... She is totally rude, clearly, and insane.
Janet, shut up.
Jets. Light of my life. Where's everybody gone?
I don't know. I haven't seen them for a while. Maybe they went to get cake.
Ha, yes. Girls in always have such a sweet tooth in my experience.
Experience? Are you a father then?
Well, no. Not really.
Oh, I just thought with you being so old.
Well, actually, you and me are quite alike in age from some perspectives.
What perspectives?
Well, you know.
Let's pretend I don't, though. Let's pretend I have no idea what you're talking about. Let's pretend I really am as gullible as you want me to be. Then what? I give you a little kiss, undo a button, or two, or three. No, I don't think so.
I'll have you know I'm a very respected member.
Really? Could have fooled me.
I'll fail you. I'll fail all three of you.
With all due respect, sir, rack off.
I'm really sorry. I know it's not good, not even saying it, but I really, really am. I don't know what happens to me around Janet. She's a good person. She really is.
Maybe to you. Maybe only to people she likes. I don't know. But look, I don't think you're awful.
I don't know, I could be.
I won't rule it out then. I get so frustrated. People expect things from me because of how I look, because of who I am, who my parents are, my heritage, stuff like that. It's like they think they know all about me and it doesn't matter what I say or what I do. It's like they've already decided what to hear. You know, it really isn't right.
It isn't. I'm sorry we didn't do anything for you.
You could have helped.
I know.
You didn't.
I'm sorry.
Don't say you're sorry.
What do I say then?
Say you won't let it happen again. To me, to anyone you see. Don't just stand there and think, oh, how sad it is, and then do something else. If you see it, if you know it's wrong, you can help.
I'll say something to Janet about all this. She tried to turn it into something it wasn't. I don't think she wanted to admit it was happening. I don't know why.
To cope, maybe? I don't know.
Maybe. But I'll talk to her. I feel really bad about leaving her behind, you see.
Yeah, I hadn't thought. We should go back.
We should? You'd want to? Even though she...
Yes, we've got to.
Girls, have you all gone mad? Girls?
Oh, look.
I packed some absolutely delicious lunch.
It's Janet. She must have run. Do you want to catch her up?
Yes. Although,
yes.
Can I throw a gum nut at her? I think I deserve that.
Yeah, just the one.
Ow! Who was that? Sue?
Shh! You'll hear us. We'll climb down to you.
Is Mary there?
I am. Is that going to be a problem?
No, whatever. Let's just leave before he catches up.
Okay.
Oh my God, we're quite high up. Oh, it's ridiculous. Ah, yes, there they are. Maybe if I could cut them off from the right, just a little bit, and maybe grab a rock, stun them or something, and then... Who the hell are you?
I'm Charlie. I hear you're a professor.
Well, I'm flattered.
Also, I hear that you're scum.
What?
Yeah, you know, scum. 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 I know what you want to do. You're going to force all of them. You're a disgusting man!
I have no idea what you're talking about. I'll take you to court, I hear you. You hear me. Who do you think they'll believe? I mean, look at the wretched state of you. You look like you've been living in a ditch.
You won't be taking me to court. I didn't fight a war and see good men die. See men like you walking around the place like nothing happened. I will not stand idly by.
Well, some of us didn't have to participate in that war because, let's just say we're a little bit higher on the evolutionary ladder.
Do you know who invited her?
No. Ellen.
I certainly didn't tell her to come.
We know
Do you know? Either of you?
No. We don't.
No, we don't know nothing.
Anything, Rowan.
Right, we know anything. We know nothing. We don't know anything.
What we're trying to say is nobody thinks this is your idea.
They better not.
Calm down. Come on. What's the worst that can happen?
The worst thing. You really want to hear it? The worst thing would be if this Serena or Selena or whatever it is. I didn't even think that's her real name. She probably picked it out because it sounds spiritual or dramatic or something. Her real name's probably Bertha or Harriet.
Wait, how is that the worst that can happen?
Sorry, all I mean is that even her name is made up. The worst thing that can happen is if this Serena ruins everything. Everything we've worked for and the rock will be destroyed.
Laura, come on, calm down. Come on, take a deep breath. No one is going to destroy the rock, especially not because of some spirit medium, okay?
All I need is one good excuse. We have to focus on the ecological merits and our unique fauna, not on mystic ghosts.
But, Ellen, that's what we do. That's what we focus on every night, and me and Ruby help.
Ruby and I.
Right, but this Serena woman, this mystic stuff, it's all just a silly little distraction.
Silly little. You do realise that we have a reporter coming tomorrow, and if he finds that we have a spirit person here...
We won't tell him. We'll keep him and Serena on opposite sides of the rock.
Oh, it's just old Charlie. He's all right.
All right, am I? I don't recall being bloody arsed.
Charlie, come sit and talk some sense into Ellen. She is in hysterics because she thinks Serena is trying to turn the protest into a laughing stock.
She is though, isn't she?
Charlie!
Oh, I knew it! Even Charlie knows it.
Hush your bloody mouth, whippersnapper. You never let an old man bloody speak.
Sorry, Charlie. I'm just so
stressed.
Yes! Well, I'm sorry. Please, continue, Charlie.
What I was going to say because of them before I was rudely interrupted
was that I know a thing or two about these spirit medium types. After the war was right popular, families wanting to see their sons again, only they never did. Not even a body. It was actually kind of sad.
Yes, actually, that's right. I read once in a book about how spirit mediums are surging in popularity after traumatic events.
Oh, I know it's true, I just told you, didn't I? But what I'm trying to say is, I've had past experience with these guys. None of them lasted more than a few days at most. Once the Serena woman finds out we don't have any flushing toilets, she'll be out before I can say sales, or I'll eat my bloody hat.
You really think so, Charlie?
I know so. Seen it before, seeing it now, no question.
See? All that worrying for nothing.
And Charlie, when the reporter comes tomorrow, we're just saying it would probably be best if we kept him away from Serena. And from Brittany and Laura too, they're almost as bad as her in the moment. We really don't need that sort of fuss.
I'll do my part. When's the man arriving?
About one-ish, I think.
I'll do my part. And don't worry about Brittany and Clara. They're young. They'll snap out of it.
Sure they will.
Mark my words.
Let me take you out for dinner, old man. You've been a saint.
It will work out, won't it?
Sure it will. Easy as. As long as we keep this cameraman focused on what we're really here for and well away from that silly lot, we'll be set.
I was wondering, you're really good at playing the guitar.
I am really good at playing the guitar? Or you were wondering if I was?
Oh no, you're really good, you're really good. I was wondering if I could learn.
Of course you could, go to a lesson.
No, I mean, one-on-one, just for me.
Far too busy, I'm afraid. And hungry too. Dinner's calling. Damn.
Billy, that was the worst footage I've ever seen. And get that bloody thing out of your mouth. You're not artistic. Hello? Hello? I'm in the right place?
What?
Hello? Is anybody here?
No.
Who's that? Who's here?
Nobody.
I'm talking nobody.
Yeah.
This isn't the Odyssey. I can't be talking to nobody.
You know what they say about people who talk to nobody? They're mad! You must be mad.
I'm not mad. I'm just looking for the protest group. You know, the ones trying to stop the bulldozing of the rock. Are you a protester?
Do I look like I'm a protester?
All right. So, I was phoned by Ellen, so I should have come early. Do you know where she is?
No.
Do you know where anyone is?
I know where I am.
Anyone apart from you?
I think Serena and that lot are down by the river that way.
Brilliant! Thanks for your... Never mind.
Who is that?
Who is who?
That man.
Oh, that was nobody.
Nobody, was it? And did this nobody have a name?
I didn't ask. Nobody can't have a name if they're nobody.
Was he looking for Ellen?
Might have been.
So you told him where Ellen was?
No.
Damn it, Fletcher! Where did you send the bloody man?
Calm your farm! I sent him down to Serena and that lot over there!
Damn! Damn! Flex!
Much ado about nothing.
Water is power. Water is power. Say it with me. Water is power. Water is power.
But how is water power?
It powers those hydroelectric station thingies, obviously.
No, heavens no. Don't think about things like that. When I say water is power, I mean water is a symbol. Water is a transmitter of spiritual power.
How? Can you explain? I think I want to be a medium when I'm older, so this is the sort of thing I'll have to be an expert on.
Water runs through everything. Through our bodies, through the trees, through the lake, through the clouds above.
There aren't any clouds today.
Shut up. You're ruining it.
I can tell you two have a lot of passion in you. The young always do. If you take my hands now and we are still in concentrated, we might be able to reveal the truth of the water. Eyes closed now. Take a deep breath in and out. We are on an ocean. The shores cross the sand, seas rising, falling, rising, falling.
I feel seasick.
Sway with me, girls, gently, side to side. You are on a lake. We are the lake. Be the lake. Be the lake.
Hurry up, Billy! When we get home, we are doing aerobics. Hello? Is anybody there?
I think I can hear the river. It's speaking to me.
Excuse me?
I don't think that's the river.
Is one of you Serena?
And who are you? It's very rude, very inappropriate to interrupt a water ritual like that. I could have fainted. When connecting to the water, one cannot be disrupted by externals.
I'm sorry, I wasn't an external? Anywho, I would love to hear what you guys talk about. Are you guys Ellen protesters?
Sort of.
In a manner of speaking. My name's Serena, and I am a spirit medium. I've been drawn here to help the land.
That's
and I'm Brittany, and this is Lara. We're helping.
Okay, next time don't interrupt me. But that's lovely, guys. I didn't know anything about spirit mediums. I thought I'd be talking about greenies, talking about ecosystem. But I'm sure the world would love to hear all about your story.
And what a story it is. There are many non-believers here, many too shut down, too closed to access any of the higher truths.
Oh, I'm sure the world would love to see your point of view.
Sit down, young man. Sit down and get your camera rolling. We have plenty to talk about before my seance tonight.
A seance? Tonight?
Yep, it's going to be at the Rock, and it's going to be really exciting. And we're going to see real live spirits.
But not real live spirits, because spirits are dead.
Not always, my dear. Some spirits are very much alive, and you're more than welcome to attend.
Brilliant, just brilliant. I'm so glad I found you all. Thank you so much, Serena. It was such an eye-opening talk.
We were happy to oblige.
And maybe when I'm famous, you could come back and interview me again, like a before and after thing. That would be so cool.
Sure, darling. In the future, far future. Anyway, we'll be at the seance. Come on, Billy. Get up. We'll meet you there. Bye, darling.
I'll see you tonight.
He was really cool, wasn't he? And we're gonna be on TV. And everyone in my class will see it. I'll get my mom to record it and everything.
This is like the start of my medium career. When I'm a proper medium, I'm going to summon all the best celebrity ghosts, like Marilyn Monroe. And, well, mostly Marilyn. It will be amazing.
I heard you spoke with Tobias Jones.
Yes, we did. Is that a problem?
Depends. What'd you talk about?
Spirits, water in the rocket. See, yeah, see.
It's pronounced seance.
Serena?
Yes, they're quite right. Tobias interrupted a water ritual and was quite fascinated by our connection to land. We each gave personal interviews.
And what'd you say in these personal interviews? Was it all just spirits?
Well, firstly, my personal interview was quite that. Personal. I don't see why you, of all people, should be lecturing me. And secondly, yes, I did talk about spirituality. I am a spirit medium.
It's absolutely my business. We're not here to talk about spirits, to talk to the water. We're protesting because the government is trying to sell and destroy this land. Did you protest, talk about that at all? Or was it all just silly, woozy spirit stuff?
Spirit stuff is not woozy or silly. I'm going to be a spirit medium too one day, so I should know.
Look, Lara, I know you're impressed by Serena, but she's, well...
Well,
What? What am I, according to you? Yeah. A fraud? There have been all sorts of theories about this rock. Mine is no better or worse than any other. Mine is the truth. I've felt it, seen it.
Sure you have, lady, but you ain't been listening. We are not here to talk about your theory this time. We're here because, spirits or no spirits, this rock is going to be destroyed unless we do something.
Exactly. Like Ruby said, and you aren't doing anything sitting around here making funny voices.
It's not just funny voices, it's real.
It's okay, Brittany. These people are what I call closed. Too shut down to access anything about themselves.
Excuse me, are you calling me closed-minded?
Well, I suppose if the shoe fits.
I'm not saying you're wrong, not necessarily. You could be the real deal expert in the spirit world for all I care. But this is a lot more than just about theories this time. The rock will be destroyed. Everything here will be.
A true tragedy, really. I know. That's why I'm here. The earth drawed me to the place. I'm here to help, really. And you can do it in your way. I'll do it in mine.
Fine. But I don't want you talking to Tobias again.
That won't be possible.
What? Why not?
Well, I told him about my seance night. He was rather impressed. Said he'd film it.
You've got to be kidding me!
No. It's going to be so cool. It's going to be on TV and everything. Serena is going to make us all so famous!
This is the last thing we need. When we're discredited for being a bunch of loonies and the rock is destroyed, I hope you're sorry then.
Really, I am trying to help her. We're on the same side.
Maybe we are. Maybe we are on the same side. Maybe we do want the same things. But the way you're going about getting it, hogging our one chance at the media attention for your silly, woozy spirit stuff? No, I can't agree with that.
She has been working so hard for this place, trying to save it. And you swarm in like you know everything? Ha! Good luck.
I agree with them.
Do you? I sense uncertainty and fear.
I'm not afraid of you, or of ghosts, or whatever.
Great. Then I'll see you at the seance tonight, of course, unless you're too busy.
I'll be there supporting Ruby and Ruby.
Was Ellen crying? I think she was crying.
She's just upset. It's hard for such closed people to be confronted with the truth.
Can we talk to the water again? That was fun.
Sure, but not here. The energy's been quite ruined. Come along.
I don't blame you, Charlie.
That's right kind of you, dear. I blame myself. These old legs and lungs, they're no bloody use in a crisis.
Don't talk yourself down. Really? You're one of the toughest 200-year-olds I know.
Hush that bloody chatter.
It's just, I feel so awful and so guilty too.
Guilty? What on earth do you feel guilty for?
I'm not close-minded, am I?
No!
What's this then? What's this bloody nonsense?
I was so rude to her and so awful. Dismissive of her beliefs, and that's not who I am as a person. Or maybe it is. Just because it seems silly to me doesn't mean it is.
Don't fuss yourself up, Ellen. I can guarantee you Serena ain't feeling guilty. You're not intolerant. You're just stressed. It's hard work and it's upsetting, and anyone would be feeling bad.
I know. And when I'm not feeling guilty, I'm feeling furious. Like, really rip their faces off angry. Because we need to save this place. And even if they are trying to help, it's not going to help.
Now, I've been having some thoughts about the seance tonight. Just in bloody time, boy. I'm about to tell you all how to sit through a seance.
You've been to one before? Was it awful? I wasn't going to come at first.
There's nothing to it. So long as you don't get scared of ghosts or the dark or mostly anything to do with the dark.
Oh great, nothing to be afraid of then.
Back in my day we had a bunch of tricks. Luminous paint, they'd roll marbles across the floor, hit hidden pockets, any trick you like.
So, we should keep our eyes open then, try to look for bits of string or something. Catch her out, is that what you're saying?
Perhaps. Might well happen. Of course, she'll probably ask us to close our eyes and hold hands. But if we make sure that we stay by each other, we'll know not to let go and say anything at all we want.
Wait, hand-holding?
Yes, that sounds like a good idea. We can sit by each other and keep each other company. Deal?
Deal.
Deal.
Is everybody comfortable? Everybody warm? Tobias, is the camera going
okay? It looks fantabulous.
Can somebody shift over? I'm sitting on it!
Oh! Ants! You know, ants. Small, biting little creatures, related to wasps and bees.
Oh. Wait, bees?
Flesh, take this and put over the ants.
Did somebody say bees? I'm allergic to bees.
There are no bees here, Rowan. Shut up.
Shut it up.
Come on. When is this starting?
I want to see 20 ghosts at least.
I'll see more than you.
You will not. You're short-sighted. You need glasses.
Girls, you don't need glasses to see the signs. Just an open mind.
So a blind person can see the signs?
What?
So say a blind person had an open mind. Could they still see the signs?
I've never held a seance with a blind person before. I don't know. Tobias, are you ready to start? It's getting quite late now.
We're ready as Geronimo.
Lovely. Everybody, hold hands so that we form a circle.
Why a circle?
A circle is infinite. It has no beginning and end, and thus has infinite power.
So a square wouldn't work?
No.
What about an oval?
Now that we're all holding hands, I want you to take a few deep breaths. In and out. In and out.
Why is the breathing so important? We don't have a lot of time anyway.
But now you're thinking about it, concentrating, focusing. The air being taken into your lungs and then releasing. Everybody, eyes closed now. I can feel the energy. Everybody hold on tight. Tight. So that none of us...
Serena, are you okay?
Child. Young on such an ancient land.
Serena, tell us. Who? Who can you see?
Dark hair, dark eyes. There are stories running through their veins like blood. There is nothing here they don't know.
This is brilliant!
The rock, the carvings, the fire is high, and the shapes seem to glide across the stone. They seem to dance. Pushing! The old man is young again. He won't let me go. He's forcing me. The pressure is falling. Screaming! Who are you? Scum! I will not stand idly by!
Oh. Serena! Serena! Ruby, take a pulse!
Billy, the camera! Is she going to die? Oh my god, this is awful!
Rowan, take Ellen, take Tobias, take them back to their tent. They don't need to see this.
Fun?
You think so?
Yeah, don't do it every night. You reckon she's faking?
I don't know anymore. I really don't know. I always just thought...
You're alright, old man? You look dead pale. Maybe just dead.
I'm fine. I'm just getting a bit too old, please.
Alright, Grandpa, come with you, just in case you fall over again.
How's her breathing?
Better.
It's Ellen. You collapsed. Can you remember anything?
The rock. I remember the rock.
Can you sit up?
Have you got any water?
Tobias, put that damn camera down and go fetch the woman some water!
Right, water. Bill, come here! Bill, you drunk. This is whiskey. All right. Here you go. It was lovely footage.
You'll worry about that later. Serena, have a drink. Thank you. Has this happened before? Is there someone we should call?
It happens sometimes. It's fine, don't worry. All I usually need is some food and water, really.
Tobias, go fetch her a biscuit.
Oh, biscuits. Billy, come here! These ones, oh, God, they might be a bit ant-covered.
But just toss the ants off, they won't kill you.
All right, you did it.
Thank you. You're being so kind. I thought you hated me.
I never hated you, Serena. I'm so sorry. I just...
It's fine now. You've made up for it now.
I still feel so sorry. I'll take care of you now. And put the rest behind us.
Yes, I'd like that.
Come on then. Let's get you somewhere safe.
Nobody ever thinks to pick up after themselves. It's not like it's in horrible and...
It's all gone!
What? What's gone?
Everything! Everything we filmed! It's poof!
Are you serious?
I'm bloody serious. To go look at it. All you see is Serena falling down, then nothing.
And you sure you recorded it?
I'm sure I bloody recorded it. My boss is going to slaughter me.
Don't panic. You can interview me. Ellen and Rowan too. You'll still have plenty of footage to submit.
You would do that for us?
Yeah, of course, we'd be happy to.
Thank you so much. You don't think it could have been?
What?
You know, spirits something.
I don't know.
It must have been. You hear about spirits, melting film, destroying cameras. Oh God. Billy, I need a lighter.
Melted film! And look who's left to clean up. Typical.
So how is she?
Serena? Nah, she's fine. Once she had a bit of food and water in her and a good night's sleep, she was back on her feet strong as an ox. She's leaving this afternoon.
Leaving? Well, I did predict it. Did she say why?
Another calling, she said. She said she's needed somewhere overseas, somewhere northern. Something to do with swamps being drained, and apparently she can hear swans calling out to her in despair or something.
Wait. Swans.
Yeah, something like that. Another calling as far as she's concerned. I didn't tell her about Tobias' lost footage either.
No?
Nah, well, I didn't want to disappoint her. And, well...
Well, what?
Well, I didn't want to dob you in either. I saw you pick up the camera, Charlie.
Ellen, I need...
Charlie, I don't mind. Maybe I should, but I don't. I know you're just trying to help.
Trying to help? Yeah. To be honest, I think I was trying to help myself a bit too. To be perfectly honest, Serena got and gave me a bit of a fright.
Serena gave you a fright? Why?
Oh, well, that's ancient history now, huh? But I will tell you this. Old men will keep their secrets.
Yeah. Well, maybe I don't know why you did it, but I'm glad you did. Thank you.
Ellen? Ellen, where are you?
I'm sitting with Charlie, over here. Follow my voice.
Just finished my interview with Tobias.
How'd it go?
Fine. He'll probably be with Serena this afternoon once he's finished with Rowan. Still has no idea how he lost his camera footage though, but it sure was an excellent bit of luck for us, wasn't it?
Does he still think the spirits did it?
Yeah, and I think Serena has got herself a new fan, actually.
Ellen, Ruby, where are you all?
We're all sitting together, over here.
You know, he's very keen on you.
I know.
And, you came back?
Well, never mind.
Tobias is just packing up now.
God, it feels like he only arrived 5 minutes ago.
Do you have any theories, Rowan?
Theories?
On how Tobias lost his camera footage. He thinks it was a ghost. I think he did it himself. He must have. Just accidentally or something, he must have pressed delete. Although, somebody could have been quite the sneaky pants and done it behind his back while he wasn't looking. That would have been quite impressive.
Oh, yeah, actually, it was me.
You?
Excuse me?
Oh, yeah, I kind of, you know, I ended up sitting next to the camera and I thought, well, I wasn't going to get another chance to do anything, so I just did it then.
I never would have guessed.
Well, you don't know everything about me.
I guess not, no. That was quite quick thinking.
Yeah, it was, wasn't it?
You're it!
I'm not. Hi, everyone.
I thought you girls were Serena.
We were, but she wanted to pack without us.
We don't mind. I don't think a seance is a very good job, either. It's quite horrible sometimes.
Yeah. I'm glad to hear it, girls.
You need to apologize to Ellen, girls. You've caused a right fuss, and you know it.
Charlie.
I'm sorry, Ellen.
We really do mean it.
Yeah. And now you're it.
Cheats!
Isn't that lovely?
Yeah, it is.
Rowan, did you still want to learn how to play the guitar?
Yeah.
Well, I guess I could show you some things. Just some basics, if you want.
Yeah, that would be really great, yeah.
Come on, then.
Well, would you look at that?
Young love.
No thanks to you, really.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Well, I do. All's well that ends well. But I gotta go catch Brittany and Lauren out. They're heading towards an awful ant's nest. Well, they found it. Catch you later, Charlie.
All's well that ends well. And it has ended well, hasn't it? I think so.
Everyone, and I just really want to acknowledge all the cast here because they dedicate so much time and energy and they really bring it every time, and I'm always speechless and I don't want to get upset, so let's just one more. I know you all love my character. I think I was the best. I was the rock.
Well acted.
Thank you. I think I kept very still. I don't think any of you saw me blink. It has been an absolute pleasure working with these guys this last semester. I remember when I was one of them on stage, being terrified in front of you all and watching you all blink at me and be like, please laugh. Please. So thank you all so much for laughing every time. There's a funny thing. It's like the greatest feeling for us on stage. It really is. I have watched some of these guys grow from very shy, very gangly, very awkward little people, and it is an honour to see them here tonight. So proud of every single last one of them. And I am leaving after this, so it is amazing to see how much each of them have grown in these roles. As reading these scripts and seeing that the words just sort of being read in a monotone voice to now, like, Lily, like, nearly making me cry on stage. of wonderful Lily, can you please step forward? Can Emily... This is our beautiful costume team. And they have done all the work, putting all this together, led by this lady right here, with her beautiful little minions. And all of this couldn't be possible without Sharon. Boston City Council's community grants that made this all possible. Can we have a round of applause for them, please? And our other main people, Tamika, who quickly ran in and helped when I couldn't. And of course, my beautiful sister, who wrote the whole thing. And did an amazing job. And now I'll pass you over to the other beautiful Amy. Back over to you. Sorry to keep you all up all night, but we've got the flowers. So we're just going to present the flowers with the little spiel. So that's wonderful. Thank you all, guys. There's a comment book at the back, so if you want to just, you know, scribble down any words of encouragement or any feedback, we always thrive off that. So thanks all of you for coming out tonight. And we really appreciate it. So hope you have a good evening. Bye.